Well, friends, this is Jim with Science Talk. In a recent video that I just posted, I discussed at length isotopic fractionation. And in that video, I walked you through some data, looking at some figures and graphs, and explained to you how we can use that information to reconstruct what has happened before in Earth's past, such as climate, temperature regimes, and other information. I also was trying to explain what the whole DEL, be it O18, C13, what is meant by the fractionation. And I was always putting it in terms of, for example, oxygen 18 relative to oxygen 16, carbon 13 relative to carbon 12. And basically it's talking about getting more positive, getting more negative, and other such values. It occurred to me that perhaps those explanations weren't as clear as they probably should have been. So we kind of consider this as this video as an addendum and as a way to hopefully explain the whole idea of fractionation. And then with that in mind, after hopefully this explanation clarify things for you, you can then go back to that video and perhaps have a better understanding of it if you had any lingering uncertainties about what was presented there. So really the best way to, the best example I could think of to explain the whole idea of fractionation is this following example. And keep in mind, when I presented the talk, I said something along the line that 99.8% of all oxygen atoms are of the 16 isotope variety, the remaining 0.2% of the 18 variety. And basically, I was always talking about the ratio of 18 to 16, always in terms of being relative to that. So, in my example, let's say I have 10 red marbles. And these 10 red marbles will represent the heavier isotope of whatever element. And I'll place those 10 red marbles in a jar of 1,000 white marbles. And the white marbles will represent the lighter isotope, the isotope that's more prevalently occurring in nature. So now, what is my fraction? What is the ratio of red to white? It will be 10 to 1,000. Or 1 to 100 when you do the reduction, which is equal to 0.01. Okay, so there's that's my fractionation. So now let's say I go into that jar and I remove 100 white marbles. I still have the 10 red marbles in there, but I've taken out 100 white marbles. Now I have 10 red marbles to 900 white marbles. So that becomes 1 over 90, which is then becomes 0.0111 repeating. Now 0.0111 is a larger number than 0.0100, etc. So therefore, we see that the fractionation has what? Increased. The number of red marbles did not change, but the fractionation went up relative to the white marbles, right? When I had 10 in 1,000, it was 0.01. I have 10 in 900, it's now 0.0111, etc. That's the idea, you know, like using that as the oxygen, you know, the 18 relative to the 16. Now, conversely, let's say in that jar of 1,000, I add 100 white marbles. I still have the 10 red ones, so now I have 10 to 1100, which is 1 to 1 over 110, which now is equal to 0.0090909, the 09's repeating. Now, 009 is less than 010, so now we see that the fractionation has what? Decreased. Again, in all my examples, it's the number of red marbles stayed the same, but it was relative to the white marbles. That is basically the idea behind when we do the measurements of the fractionation. It's the, and we're using oxygen as an example, it's the number of O18 atoms relative to O16 atoms and how that changes relative to each other. And the same argument can be made for C13 to C12, N15 to N14. And, you know, likewise, if you wanted to look at deuterium and tritium, etc. But that is really the basic idea behind the fractionation. We look at those changes, and then we can, by looking at those changes, we then know what the trend was. Oh, it's becoming more, the fractionation is increasing, it's decreasing. And we then use that information to reconstruct what has happened in the past. So, I said, I just wanted to make this video as an example to hopefully better illustrate and clarify what's the whole idea behind what fractionation is all about. So, hope you find this informative and clarifies any confusions that might have been there when you looked at that lengthy video. Thank you for your time, and we'll talk soon.